Okay. Well, let's try this again. I quickly watched back that last video from my living room, and it was a bit of a disaster. I think the acoustics were just too forgiving in there with the curtains, the carpet, the sofas. So I've dragged everything out here into the living room, onto the dining table now. So have a quick go again. This is a 10-person dining table. This area is 4 meters by 3 meters, glass all the way around it, solid tiled floor. There's no curtains, nothing soft at all. So this is going to be the most challenging acoustic environment to test these microphones in. So let's give it another try. Got it set up just as you would with a hybrid meeting. Got a camera up over there that will be able to see everything. And I've got a few microphones set up, but after watching back some of the footage from the last one, there's a couple that I've just decided to remove just to get a better comparison. So I'm currently on the MXL AC44, the predecessor, the AC404. Can't see it very well in this light. The older generation of the AC404. I wanted to see if there was much difference between this and the newer AC44. It turns out on Zoom, there's no perceivable difference. On the spec sheet, okay, there's a little bit of difference. And maybe if you're doing some high quality recording without compression, without automatic gain control, maybe the AC44 would get a little bit of advantage. But I've got rid of that one. My wireless lapel mics. Yeah, the sound was really clear. It was really good quality. But although it gave a baseline, it wasn't really comparable to any of these other boundary mics, desktop mics that we're kind of testing it against. And as this is meant to demonstrate how these microphones operate in a hybrid environment, I thought let's just remove those to also level the playing field a little bit. The expansion microphones that plug into to plug into both the Polycom 8800 and to plug into the E-Link, I decided to just remove them. So I've got all four of these expansion mics disconnected. Of course, if you do need more range, if these central desk phones don't work well enough as microphones, then sure, you can still plug those in, but it's just a lot more cable in, a lot more hassle. So I just wanted to try and slim this down to just a single microphone approach. So anyway, that should give us a good baseline on the MXL44, AC44, one of my favorite go-to mics, really compact, easy, chuck it in a bag, works with laptops, smartphones, anything. So let's flick over now to the one that I hope is gonna. Oh, actually, I need to just give a little bit of range test for sure. I'm sat right next to it, it's gonna sound okay. So let's just take a seat over here. And if I continue speaking at the same volume, there we go. Also, it would be interesting to see how the background noise is because it's very heavy rain outside right now. To my ears, I can hear it, it's quite prominent, but it would be interesting to see how the microphones deal with that. And also, in conjunction with the Zoom automatic gain control and noise cancellation algorithms that Zoom uses, be interested to see how they filter through the background noise that's in here. This should really be about the most challenging environment. So that should give us give you a bit of an idea. At the moment, I'm almost the 4 meters from the microphone. So almost 4 meters in a terrible acoustic environment. Let's try again now with what's next on it. Okay, we're gonna go over to the Samsung UB1. Hopefully that's on the Samsung UB1. The advantage with the Samsung UB1 over the MXL AC44 is that it is omnidirectional. So it should pick up evenly and it sits in the middle of the table. The AC44, because it's directional, sits at the end of the table and fires down. So sure, the people at this end of the table, they're going to be picked up really well, but the effectiveness of it is going to decrease as it moves down here. Whereas with the Samsung UB1, in my previous testing, it didn't seem to have quite the clarity of the MXL microphone. But being omnidirectional, and again, it's just a small little puck, one USB cable, no external power needed. It's got a light on it, just like the MXL, so you know when it's working and operating. Works as a boundary microphone. Just pop it down and you're good to go. So in theory, any seat, even behind the camera, should be picking me up quite evenly. And there shouldn't be a great deal of variation as I move around the table. As long as I'm still kind of focusing my voice towards the center of the table, it should pick me up evenly. So hopefully that's a fair test of the Samson mic UB1. Let's move over now to one of the speaker phones. There we go. I've just selected the wrong one. That is the inbuilt microphone on my Dell XPS laptop. Let's move over now. Okay, so now we are recording on the Polycom Trio Real Presence 8800. It was Polycom's top of the range enterprise grade desk speakerphone, designed for boardroom, designed for a conference room. It's one of the products that is more aimed directly towards this market. In some of my previous testing, I wasn't really massively impressed with how it performed, considering it's enterprise grade and the price tag on it is absolutely extortionate new. I picked these up very cheap off eBay, and just powering it using a PoE injector to get the power into it. And then they just run a standard like a USB microphones. It has the advantage of also having quite a good speakerphone in it, so you can hear the people on the other end of the Zoom call really well with it. And of course you can then plug in extension microphones, which is one of the downsides of one of the other standalone USB microphones. Anyway, that should give you an idea. I guess another advantage, you may, camera's a bit far away. So it does have a touch screen. It's almost like a smartphone interface, Bluetooth as well, so you don't have to use it by USB. Also has on every corner, if I tap this, so you could, maybe you can just about see that all the corners go red to show that you've muted the call. So yeah, it's got a few more features, but really I'm just talking about the audio. How the audio performs is the biggest concern here. Okay, so let's go ahead and we're going to switch over onto the Yealink CP960. Okay. I'm not sure that the Yealink is working correctly. All right, let's try that again. I had to pause the recording for a second. We're having some technical difficulties with the Yealink. So it's now definitely functioning. I don't see a huge difference in performance in my previous video between the Yiling CP960 and the Polycom Trio Real Presence 8800. There is a few differences in the way they function, but they're very, very comparable. The Yiling, the loudspeaker on it, so what we hear from the participants at the other end, is considerably louder than the Trio 8800. Not to say that the Trio 8800 is bad by any means. They're both more than adequate for this kind of environment and having some sort of hybrid meeting. But I'll be interested to see in this more challenging environment, because these devices both have some sort of noise cancellation algorithm built into their device, as well as having the Zoom algorithms over the top as well. I'll be interested to see how they now perform. So let's see if we can just have a quick flip through. This is on the Yiling CP960. This is on the MXL AC44. This is on the Samsung UB1. This is on the Dell XPS. And let's just have a little try here and see if we can get the Trio 8800 back alive. Okay. Right. So if we flick over. So this is the Polycom 8800. Check, check, test, test. This is the Yiling CP960, test, test, check, check. This is the Samsung UB1, check, check, test, test. Okay, hopefully that has done the job, and we can see a clear performance difference in this much more challenging environment.